Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is a new YouTube tutorial series. In this, I will be introducing you some STEM projects. Of course, all these projects will be simple and easy. So please try it out.
This one is a simple prototype of a DC motor. Let us see the theory behind the working of a DC motor. A DC motor or a motor is working on Fleming's left-hand rule. This is the rule. If there is a magnetic field in one direction and there is an electric current passing through a direction which is perpendicular to the magnetic field, then there will be an electric force generated in a direction which is perpendicular to both of the forces. This diagram is more realistic. You can see the coil through which the current is passed. This is a power supply, a battery. The positive is connected to the coil through a commutator and a brush. Normally it will be a carbon brush. And negative edge is also connected to the other end of the coil so that there will be a current flowing through the circuit. And this is the magnet. South pole of the magnet is kept here, and this is the north pole. This diagram shows the forces. So this white line indicates the direction of the magnetic flux from north pole to the south pole of the magnet. This is the direction of the index finger according to Fleming's law. And this yellow line is the direction of the flow of electricity. This is the middle finger according to the illustration of Fleming's law. And the red line, this is the direction of the rotation of the motor, which is mutually perpendicular to both other two forces. There are three forces applied. All three forces are mutually perpendicular. Here we have a little animation of this theory. You can see the magnet, north and south poles, and these lines are the magnetic lines from north to south, and there is a battery to power the coil, and there is an electricity flowing through this coil. The yellow dots are the flow of electricity. Once if the electricity is flowing through the coil, then the coil itself, if it is wound on a shaft, the coil itself starts rotating. This is more realistic picture of a motor. You can see the magnet. Magnet is mostly in a round shape. And in between the magnet poles, there is a shaft connected, and around the shaft, the coils are wounded. There could be many number of coils wounded, not necessarily one. Once if the electricity is supplied through the connectors, positive and negative, then electricity start flowing through the coils. Once the flow of direction of electricity and the magnetic force is mutually perpendicular, and if it start working, then the shaft on which the wires are wounded start rotating. This is how the motors are working. We have a commutator and a carbon brush here because the coil itself is moving, and we have to give a supply to the moving coil. So there are two connectors here. Those are called brushes or carbon brushes. They will be touching this commutator. Commutator is getting electricity from this battery, and it is going through this coil. At the same time, we have the same kind of carbon brush and a commutator here to get in touch. So this is the working of a DC motor. This one is a simple prototype of a DC motor. Coil with a copper wire, two magnets, one on the top of the battery and one at the bottom. As the magnets are placed on both directions of the battery, there is a magnetic field, and when this wire is touching both the magnets, one on the positive side and second one on the negative side of the battery, there will be an electric current flowing through this circuit. So we have a magnetic field working in one direction, electricity flowing in the other direction, then definitely according to Fleming's law, the coil should rotate in a direction which is perpendicular to both the forces. These are two powerful magnets. One is at the negative side of the battery and another one kept on the top positive side. So then keep the coil this way so that the coil will be touching both positive and negative edges of the battery, and there will be a current flowing through the coil.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope you could do this by yourself. Please try it out. If you have any questions, please post a comment. I will be definitely looking into it. Please like the video if you like it. Share with your friends. And please subscribe and stay tuned for more STEM project videos. Thank you.